I was born way back in 1986. I'm an old man now, but I remember how it used to be. And now my grandchildren ask me, "Granddad," they say, "can you tell us what it was like in the days of the internet? You know, before SOPA." And I tell them, "When was that? Let me see, sometime back in the early 21st century. I remember when the internet was free. Behind my keyboard, people let me be. See, there used to be a thing called freedom of speech. We had freedom to teach each other, freedom to preach, freedom to share culture and circulate ideas without the state trying to interfere. Lost that freedom, not freedom as in free beer, but the freedom to be free from fear. Even here in the United Kingdom, the fact that I'm from England isn't a matter that matters to our new masters and kings. I was a chap who could sing and distribute my music, and like-minded citizens could listen to it. I couldn't afford an orchestra, I was a poor performer in more ways than one. So I sought an alternate formula, reinterpreted the media around me, satirized the leader's lies on found beats, talk shop on top of a sample of a rock band, at least we used to, until rap got banned at the SOPA. In Congress, if one mess with them, then there'd be one less. Our representatives never represented shit, so the internet was history. This was the end of it. I remember it like it was yesterday. I guess the day I was too lazy to investigate the escapades of another state's government. Now I'm left to pay because the covenant that they signed that day and ratified in law zipped our mouths up and took away our appetite for more. I can't do much now about the way it is, but if I could go back and change things, I'd say this: truth is beauty, at least it used to.